Dr. Sas Biswas today again with us from Dolphin Institute, and he has a beautiful flower with him. I see marigold. Doctor, what is it about?
You must be wondering, you've seen many flowers, but not so much, so many, whether it's one or many, but when you remove it, you will say, is one, is no many. Is one and many like that, you know, you go on removing this. But I must tell you that this is a composite flower. That is why it was in family composite now yesterday, see. But all flowers, there are different flowers. So you'll find around them, they're all in disc. But if you see the sunflower, there's a disc and the rays. And ray flowers are there. There you can show you the photo frame. There is one sunflower like that. You see in the center, there's a disc flower, or you can say the disc florets. And here all these are disc flowers. So I go on removing them, and you see at the base, these are the bracts, green color structure, and on this one, you'll find there is a kind of a head. And this is where all the flowers are arising. So what I do, so many florets have come. They are all rare florets. So what I do, I take one of them, and as you can see here, blackish structure. And this blackish structure, if I draw it, it will come up like this at the base and here, and then what we see, the single petal. In fact, this is none but as many as five of them. They are all united, forming a tongue-like, or what we call it, ligulate. And this is the ovary, black color. You can just see here and ovary, and here this is what is known as calyx, or the sepal, which is quite cartilaginous. You can see it in my hand. This we call it papus, and this is what makes the complete flower like that. But if we see in sunflower and all, we will find those the flowers have like this. It goes, and then the ovary down. And here the papus, and here, and here they, you know, as many as this, many of stamens arise, and they're all attached around. And like this one, you can just see here, the stigma out here. So this is coming up, stigma, and from here, this comes stigma, and this forms a kind of the hole. So this is what is disc floret. Disc floret, and here it is a ray floret, and the composition of this makes to the family Asteraceae, and the composite. And you know, if you go with the evolution of this, it is said those same type of inflorescences were not there, or they got all compressed and it made into the kind of the head. And here you can just see here, and this is the head, and on this one can say receptacle. So the flower cells are in all heads. So this is one kind of a very special type of inflorescence, and that makes the typical of the family, plant family called Asteraceae. And you can see the black color on the bract. These are all bract. And whereas here, as I picked up and shown you earlier, and then the papus, the stigma, and down it is going this time with the ovary, the black color. And papus becomes hardened, and it gets, when it becomes matured, it gets sticken, and that helps in the dispersal of this. This is what all the ray florets. Ray florets, and you just see here And this is what is known as Ganda Phool. And you'll find many of the songs have got. You can hear.
Yes, I can.
Ganda Phool. Also is what is called a melgoat, and a very popular, one of the most relished flowers in puja, the worships. And the one in the orange color, I call it, that is even, you know, bundi ka laddu mein bhi orange color hai, aur ganda ka phool mein bhi hai, aur Diwali aane wali hai, and during the Diwali, lot of mala, garlands and puja, and the cost of this also increases. Whether you go to, you know, in Dehradun or in Bengaluru, you'll find they enjoy the very much importance. And I must tell you, this is also at the same time one of the top five plant families of the world. For its flowers, for its species, globally present in different parts of the continents of the world.
Thank you so much, Dr. Biswas. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for your curiosity.